And the inspiration continues tonight as we meet a woman who can make you believe that anything is possible. It's about a 30-year-old amputee and her quest to compete in the world's toughest race. Our Pete Fuentes traveled to Kona, Hawaii to bring you the story of this remarkable triathlete.
I have unfinished business in Kona.
Physically challenged athlete. She'd be the first woman, amputee woman, to ever do the Ironman.
Kona, Hawaii is a site for the Triathlon World Championship. It's a feat so extraordinary, it takes a will of iron to take it on.
Swim 2.4 miles. Bike 112, and then run a marathon. It's hard to get your hands around that distance. Like, that just seems unbelievable.
In 2004, it became unattainable for Sarah Reinertsen.
I had dreamed about this for years. I had worked so hard, and I came into transition when I knew that I wasn't going to be an Ironman.
The wind conditions were harsh that day. A record number of triathletes dropped out, including Sarah.
The thing is I have to finish what I started. You know, I can't walk away from this knowing I only went so far.
What goes around just comes around. This is the sound. It's time to get down.
Sarah began training early this year for her second try at Kona. She's attacking the race a much wiser, more experienced, and humbled racer.
Hey, Sarah, we gotta turn that toe out, don't we?
This time, there's no room for error or excuses, not from the weather or equipment.
You know what it is? I have to increase the resistance of the hydraulics, too.
Watch this. Now go ahead.
Okay. That's quicker, huh?
It's tracking really smooth.
Perfect.
All right, you're done.
Thanks.
Okay, nice work.
The Ironman is a test of endurance and strength for athletes and fans.
These are friends of ours, friends of Sarah's, people that she's grown up with, neighbors, and just people that love her and want to support her.
As long as Sarah can see it, it's all good.
Okay, here we go.
Nice.
All right. This year, she's going to finish her business and get it done, and we're going to be at that finish line.
Right here, right now, right here.
Into the race, Sarah feels the pressure.
This is when the nerves come.
There are those who think she's in over her head, that a person with one leg can't finish the Ironman.
The way I tap into that strength when I'm out there racing is I'll say mantras to myself. Show them what you're made of. Show them what you're made of. And I just kind of repeat that to myself over and over.
You're going to finish today, girl!
Show them you're tougher than the rest. Show them you're tougher than the rest, you know? Or come on, Sarah, throw your heart over the hill. You'll get there. Come on, throw your heart over this hill. You can do it.
It started this morning at 6:45 with the pro men and women. And here we go.
Sarah reaches her bike transition on time. She's been at it for almost 10 hours.
You're a superstar, buddy.
Now she must run a marathon.
Come on, girl. Come on, girl. You keep going. Come on, girl. That's it. As a mom, I am so proud of Sarah. She has given so much to me during this whole process, and she's taught me to never quit, always try and not give up.
With just a mile to go, Sarah can hear the crowds at the finish line.
Everything to me.
A triathlon has given a disabled athlete the opportunity to prove she's like everyone else.
Let me tell you, last year is what made this moment so sweet.
You are an Ironman!
It's finished business now.
In Kona, Hawaii, Pete Fuentes, Fox 6 News.
Ah, All of our congratulations to Sarah. We are so proud of her. And just so that you know, Sarah is the daughter of Solveig and our own Pete Fuentes.
I am so blown away.
Isn't that wonderful?
Is so
she
great.
Made it. Can you imagine starting a marathon after 10 hours of all that swimming?
I can't imagine going into the mailbox and coming back to my house without being a little winded.
She's an amazing woman.
Isn't
amazing.
She?
Amazing. Congratulations.
Yeah,
Sarah.
So
great.
Proud of her.
Oh, wonderful. Absolutely
man,
wonderful.
Man, that is amazing.
Well, okay, we can go home now.
Yeah. You done? Yeah. No, I've got to give you a forecast. And it's 59 degrees outside right now. In